गंगाधारी लेवल जी रूम में मिले उनको कड़ा चप्पल
धन्यवाद प्रभु
ఓకే ఆశీర్వాద మీ దగ్గర జపమాలా ఉంది
అంటే ఆయన లేదు అందుకని తీసుకోమని
వెరీ గుడ్ Because I was a little scared to take you out. You would have enjoyed so much.
And, at the same time, that the experience is still there, and part of the challenge in here is amplified. It's greater than anywhere else, but remaining focused with all the distractions around, whether it's traveling to the water, whether it's when you're at the Ganga and trying to get in and trying to keep your mind in the place where it wants to be when everybody's rushing and everybody's wanting you to come this way or go that way, or people are coming from different directions. That's always one of the things about India. I think that's one of the tests and the ways to train.
What happened? Why there was a rush there? Because people like me, we got 100 people, I got 50 people. Exactly. So there are 700 of us.
That's right.
All over India. So everybody has got, you know, 50 people, exactly. 30 people. I had 200, 300 people. They walked
they away and walked.
The police sent them away by walk to a different place in different ways. They're gone. But we had 40 people, 30, 40 people over there. So everybody has that many, and they're all getting down more or less at the same time.
Exactly.
They're all running, rushing.
And that, but at the same time, that's the beauty of it.
Why
right?
They are rushing? Because the car cannot be left for a long time. Because police is there. That means government police is there. They won't let you park for too long. So they have to rush and run.
Exactly.
And somebody wanted two times. They come. They came and touched me after park. They came and touched me and then went back. So you know, for that they. Most of them are like this. They come and dip inside and come back and touch their guru and then go back again. You know, they got this kind of system. Some people have this kind of system. Rushing and running, and it's only for this.
But that's India, right? And that's part of the process of me, at least, experiencing and having a chance to spend time here. Is there's nothing wrong. Nobody's rushing in a bad way. They're not being rude. They're just excited, and it's the process. And there are a million people. Everybody has to somehow get through that crack. So we got to hurry. Otherwise, we'll be here for 25 hours. So there's nothing at all that's negative.
After we all finish. Then everybody will rush in. Then, then there's no problem.
What time? So when did that begin? So after you,
after we all finished.
Which was like probably 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon.
No, 1:30.
Oh, 1:30.
1:30. So then the you see, after 1:30, sadhus cannot supposed to be there.
Oh, okay.
We're not supposed to be there. So before 1:30, 1 o'clock, we are gone. All gone.
Yeah, we were gone by 11.
So what happens is why. Some of the sadhus came back late, even 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock.
That.
Why they came back late? Because police allows, because people are rushing in. So people have to be stopped by them to make sure their vehicle goes through. So they can only stop certain moments. After that, they have to let people go too. And then the sadhus have to stop. So we are lucky we came back early.
No, we got there in the right time.
We came back early.
It was a fantastic experience. And for me, just to spend time and to kind of be in the environment is special.
I think it's very wonderful. It's wonderful. I feel a little miserable that you all are not staying till 15th, but I'm very happy that you came.
I am as well, and I think it's tastes. As you get more and more taste, you start with a little taste, then you take a swallow, and then you take a gulp, and then you can't wait to have. There's unlimited amounts that you just want to keep. And so for me, and same with business, I kind of try to expose my kids. I have to start with a little taste, just to get them interested and to.
Slowly, when they come to understand, not now, slowly train them to do little puja, and then tell them some philosophies or stories. Stories to tell is good, but with the stories, little bit philosophy, right? Why? This is like this.
And that's, to me, my favorite part. That's why I'm so, having little kids, I love doing that. And at this age, they love hearing, whether it's the stories as well as the philosophy, because part of it is teaching them how to grow up, how to behave in school, and how to deal with friends and stuff. So that, to me, that's one of my favorite parts of life, just that's being a chance to be a dad. One thing that I have not had much connection to is, and I realized, and I haven't spent time at your ashram, but all of your devotees always praise Radha throughout the day and at all times. I don't have much knowledge or sense of her character, her personality, her history. Where, how do I?
आई पंडित जी
स्वागत
learn more.
आप कहाँ थे? हमको पता ही नहीं. हम बुलाया, भूल गए बुलाना. इन पंडित जी को भी नहीं बुलाया. आ रहे हैं हम. बैठिए. भाग रहे हैं क्या? नहीं बैठ जाएंगे फिर क्या बात. अब जल्दी नहीं है तो देर सम रिलेटिव डर लेदो. खाली ऑफ చేశారు ఫోన్ చేర్ చేరిన తర్వాత ఏమీ జరగలేదు. మంచి కన్నయ్య యొక్క భక్తికి ఏమి ఉండదు. తప్పు
Not yet, because
but I told them nothing will happen. This is Rajgaru's wife.
Oh, yes.
Rajgaru, big Rajgaru's. Rajgaru means, you know, big, royal, yeah. Royal fellows.
Yeah.
And they are very, very helpful like you. Yeah. Very much.
Fantastic.
You know.
Absolutely.
They want to go fifth gear, maybe, no?
Good.
Gaura Hari! Very good. It is not a little bit. Right. She was so small. She was that small, drinking her milk, I saw when I went to their house.
Oh, yeah.
Then they came for inauguration of the temple, and there is a rule. When Christmas cut first time open, some virgin girl which is less than eight years is to be seen first by Lord Krishna. She is the one.
Oh, wow. Very fortunate.
Alright, నేను మాట్లాడుతున్నాను. నేను ఎక్కువ వెళ్ళిపోతాను ఈరోజు. इतनी सी थी जो कन्हैया का जो मंदिर इनॉग्रेशन में देखा था. नहीं है दे बिग बिजनेस दे रन ऑल स्टेट सो मेनी ब्रांचेस
multi-million
but they are now they have full time deputy means 50 lakh chanting japa and following all the rules and regulations kind of whole house is done.
Like your heart is internal, in the heart, every day, following so many rules
and reading Bhagavatam, and I think besides your house, nobody does that much. They don't have that much power.
My mom.
Yes, your mom, and then you, your father is in the center somewhere, but you and your mom are the two peak. They dug me enough, that's why I love your mommy and you. Because you take itni khudai kari in logon ne meri, ki duniya mein kisi ne dekha. Isliye iski mummy badi akalmand hai, woh bhi buddhi ho gayi. Badi akalmand hai, bahut buddhi hai uske andar. Buddhi ho gayi ab. Lekin unhone jo khudai kari aise 36 वर्ष 35 वर्ष से जानते हैं ये छोटा सा था always I remember and I tell the people sometimes they think cuckoo, you know, but their cuckoo ways, they are offensive. Exactly. I don't care because those ways did not enter in my mind in any time and any point. But these people are, because if a Swami glorifies some female, then there is a problem somewhere, you know, they think. But they are all rogues, so many of them I gave up.
That's the world.
Yeah, no problem. So why Radha Rani is Krishna's internal potency. External potency is Durga or Maya. Internal potency is Radha Rani. Radha Rani is Krishna himself. When Krishna wanted to enjoy, he thought, how I can enjoy a little more than I am. So he thought and he felt that only female can give a good kind of pleasure. So I am a male, there is nobody else besides me. So how can I get a female to have sufficient pleasure? So Krishna Karma is inside energy. I am male and I am female. He is both. He is not limited to be male. He is not limited to be not female. Therefore, he is male and female. Mata ahamasya jagatah. Mata pita ahamasya jagatah. Mata dhata pita maha. I am the father. I am the mother. How he is the mother? What is this neutral gender? Who is God? What is God? Is transsexual?
Transgender?
Yes, it's not so. Kanaiya is so. See, so what is Radha? Radha is Krishna's pleasure potency. Pleasure potency. So when why we chant Radhe Radhe? Because Krishna said, I love Radha, that's why her name is like that. When we say Radha, Madhav comes to come and see who will chant like that. So, we chant Radhe to invite Krishna. Hare means Radhe, Krishna means Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So, like that.
So, as a greeting, I don't hear many people say Jesse Krishna. You hear Radhe Radhe, you hear Hare. Why do we just say Jesse Krishna?
Because it's different states, different ways, but this is philosophically correct. Radhe Radhe. Radhe Radhe is philosophically
correct. So by my saying Radhe Radhe, I'm hopefully encouraging Krishna to come as a
figure. Yes, not only me, with you too. Desi Radhe? On the telephone, he says, I'm saying hello. This is Desi Radhe. Oh, yes. Hari Bolo? Hari Bolo means say Hari. Yeah, liberating fellow, somebody possibly will repeat it.
Right.
So we at least is hearing it. So we just saying the hello instead of saying hello, we say Hari Bol, Radhe Radhe, Jai Sri Radhe. Or we say Jai Sri Krishna or something like that. But Jai Sri Krishna is limited to Gujarat. Yes, it's limited there. Even there is not everybody says that.
Right.
So very many people they say there. There is limited there. But Radhe Radhe is all over India. Hari Bol is everywhere. Everywhere, including Gujarat.
And the stories of Radha, I know the portions when Krishna's growing up and the companionship and the dance, and I don't know though, before, are there stories about her being born and her growing up before she met Krishna, and then what happens after Krishna leaves?
See, in the spiritual world, Radha Rani. So she had to come down when Lord Krishna comes, she's gone, that Lord Krishna decided to come. Because of the curse, she was married to somebody else, openly, after they appeared. Yes.
Okay.
So she was given in marriage to somebody else, but because she's internal potency of Krishna following the curse, she united with Krishna. So parakya bhave jaha prajiti pracha. This is called paramorshika relationship. Madhurya leela gunarupana. It's called madhurya rasa. Madhurya rasa means, these pandits, they will say Madhura Rasa. It's not Madhura Rasa. Madhura means sweet. No, it's not like that. Madhura means Paramorship. Paramorship means not Sukhya, but Parakya. Parakya means not her husband, is it only lover. So this is the meaning of devotion in the spiritual life. You enjoy your wife differently than you have a woman on the side. There is more attraction there, there's lesser here.
Passion.
Not passion. This is the mood we have in devotion. We don't think that way. But we have the process, the philosophy, the feeling, the realization, the dedication, the devotion, the appreciation in this way. Parakya means extra love, extra strong strength of love in paramorship is stronger than his own merit life. So our devotion is stricter and stronger in this way. So we have in this way the devotion. So Radharani and Lord Krishna met after she's married. The history, I think I told so many people, maybe I didn't tell them. I must have told them. No, it's not.
I always ask you about Krishna.
Everything,
that's all the books are all
not in the books.
Yeah.
Because everything I cannot put in the books. Because the books will become so much. There's one volume still pending. There's no time. What is the time? I'm busy 24 hours practically. Wherever is the time? So like that. So what happens is, when Radharani met Krishna first time, if you have a chance to come to Vrindavan, I'm there. You and me alone will go. I will show you all the places, very detailed. If mommy and daddy will come, then pandas will catch us. If you and me are there, no pandas will catch, they will think they're just from here. And you know, it's not nothing extra going on. But you know, if there is more than one with me, then they will catch. and then you will trouble because they will ask you, and they will never ask me, but they will ask you, yeah, something like that. So we don't want that disturbance.
Sure.
I'll take very, very near Vrindavan. From Vrindavan, we rent a taxi and we go there. We go where Radharani met Lord Krishna first. Where Krishna met Radharani first, before marriage. How they developed that connection. Oh, many nice stories, history. These are wonderful. When we think like that, we become stronger sannyasi, stronger devotees, better. Strong means not physically, but strict devotees. So, when Radharani got married to somebody else, because she's internal and eternal consort, internal potency, pleasure potency, and eternal consort of Krishna from the spiritual world. When Krishna found that she is married to somebody else because she was cursed to do so in the spiritual world. So, Krishna wanted to have, I want to go and see. Krishna is this side. Radharani is also feeling sick because why she was cursed? But she has to go through the curse because Brahmins are like this. So what happens is, she got married, then he newly married, wedded wives, their captain side. I don't know how they kept in Gujarat, but North India, the captain side. That is process. That is the process, not just North India, but that is Indian process. Process is a newly married wife is brought and kept in the house, and relatives come because his veil is covered, they want to see the face. All this process is there. It's not just North India, but everywhere, maybe. I think, I'm not sure, I don't know. So what happens is, everybody is coming, giving a sweet box, you know, leaving a sweet box, somebody brings a sari, somebody gives gifts, you know, some gold and rings and all that. The people are coming, people not males, only females. So Krishna changed himself into a female. And mother-in-law sits outside on the door, watching who goes inside the door, or the newly wedded, and the boy is somewhere else, the man newly married, you know. So the mother-in-law is sitting there, and then Krishna passed through, and then wearing garbs of the female, and passed through and inside. He told Radharani, hey, come on, take this. You put this one, and I put yours. Did he catch me? Did he understand? So they exchanged the clothes, and Radharani walked out. Okay, now Krishna has got so many sweet boxes, and he enjoys this, and he's not a female, he's not Radharani. Krishna is sitting in everybody's heart, so Krishna made sure that everybody, no other newcomers come to see the face, because it's Krishna, no more Radharani there, so he made sure nobody comes in. So Krishna threw a rope through the courtyard, through the rope, and made Brahma catch the rope, and he climbed up and jumped on the fire. Mother-in-law is thinking, my daughter-in-law is inside. Is he? And rather, that's our devotion. Nikunja yuno ratikeli sikhi yaya libhir yuktir apekshene. Lord Sri Krishna and Radharani, they live in Nikunja Vani. In Vrindavan grows. Ami Yamuna Pulini Kadamba Kanani Kihirilu Sakhi. One gopi has desired to see Radha and Krishna sitting on a golden throne, bedecked with pearls and diamonds, in the groves of Vrindavan, which is located in the bank of Yamuna. She wanted both of them, not one. Because Krishna is not a place every time, different ways. So she did not want that. She wanted both of them. Putin is sitting in a group and Krishna is kissing Radharani. Not just kissing, but putting arms around her neck. She wanted to see that. So what happened? The gopi, when Krishna fulfills the desires of his sincere devotee, when the gopis are sincere devotees by nature, when Krishna fulfills his desires, she went to the bank of Yamuna to fetch water. She forgot to fetch water because she saw Radha and Krishna sitting. Krishna is having arm around her. Radharani is holding this way, Krishna's arm, this way, elbow of Krishna. So she saw that is kissing. But nowadays it's called putting mouth somewhere else. You see, when I came to America in 1977, I never saw man, woman kissing in my life. I saw it in Berkeley, near the university campus. First time I saw men, the woman was standing under the tree and standing there for some reason. And some man stopped the car there and he went and held her and put his mouth on her mouth. My goodness. I told Hare Krishna, look, what is happening? That is normal for them, for me, abnormal, for me, my goodness, you know, what happened? Put his mouth on her mouth. Oh my goodness, it's so dirty job. See, for me, it's a dirty job. For them, it's normal. They're all white people. You know, the white devotees. And no. What I'm telling them. They are all the same, you know. So, what is happening? Usually, in Vedic civilization, smelling the head is required. See, I smell your head. See, you don't know. It was not necessary. By smelling the head, you take all the sin sitting in the head. You put the hand on the head, pressing, then you put the hands around the body. You cannot do that because you don't have that much potential. I do like this, to remove all your diseases. Because we got that chanting, we got so much purity here, tapasya. We get that kind of potency within us. So we do that. We don't kiss here and there. But nowadays I do. But like a Muslim does to another Muslim, maybe like the distance away. You understand? Because nowadays kiss has come to this point. But it's not like that. So Krishna, Radharani doing like this. She saw who? The gopi. Because Krishna is fulfilling the desire of that devotee. Then she comes back, man. She forgot to fetch water. Then comes back and telling other gopis. Are you gopi? Oh, gopis? What did I see? Look. She gone mad. What did I see? Spiritual life is so ecstatic. You're not mad like people. You are more sane, but act so wonderfully. Look, gopis, what I saw on the back of the window. Ramasyama Bansidhari, Mani Manchapari, Basyachinya, Rasaraja. Rasaraja means Lord Krishna. He performs pastimes. That's why his name is Rasaraja. Rasaraja means pleasurable pastimes, which is jolly for him and jolly for those who see that or whoever involves hearing about it. They feel. Tushyanti Ramanchita, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, my pastimes are such, those who read, they feel pleasure, those who speak, they feel pleasure, those who hear, they feel pleasure. Every way the pleasure. It's a sack of sugar. You make a hole here, you get sugar, you make a hole there, you get sugar, you get a hole there, you get sugar, you open the top, you get sugar. So, she's saying, look, my Krishna, spiritual life is individualized and is private. We do in public because we want them to become devotees. You do not need to do in public. It is private life. Spiritual life is private. You do inside your room, chant your japa, do little puja, read Bhagavatam, go back, no tilak. Put mascara, put your powder, you put your cream, put a tie. I look like a gentleman outside, civil. But inside, you are devotee. Because spiritual life is private. So what he says, what she says, my Krishna, I saw. You see, Krishna belongs to everybody. also they are gopis too. Krishna is there too. She knows that. But no, it should not be said like that. My Krishna, I seen on the bank of Yamuna, inside the groves, sitting on the golden throne, bedded with the pearls in her ornament. The Rani, she said. Oh, they became envious. Ah, really? You saw Nagini nursing? Then they pray. Oh, Krishna, please let us see the same thing. You see? Devotee, envy is not envy to put you down, I go up. No. Envy is turns into competition. Wow. She saw, I also want to see. Then go to the temple, oh Krishna, oh Narayana, please let me see my Kanhaiya doing the same thing what she saw. Oh Lord, please. See, that is devotion. How wonderful it is. It is unimaginable.
So those stories about Nanda, are they in a particular part of the scriptures or what?
Yes.
What about after Krishna's boots, after he leaves from the
Buddha? Radharani was not born like Lord Krishna, we said. Krishna did not take birth, he appeared.
See, right.
He was already a young fellow, had four arms, conchal, disc. You have read in the Bhagavatam.
Sure.
So Krishna was also not born, but we say Krishna was born.
Just for
but Radharani was not born like that. She appeared from the earth.
At that,
yes,
at the same point that she met Krishna when she appeared? Or when she
appeared? She is almost 1 year old. She came before.
And so the story, though, from her as a 5 day old baby. They
no, it's not.
It starts when she basically
meets Krishna.
And when she got married to that person.
When she comes in connection with Krishna, then only everything begins.
And when does the story start?
Karsh stays with her until she meets first time. Siddhama, upstairs in the spiritual world,
Sridhama,
because she goes to earth and marries somebody else, not with Krishna. So she is married there.
And where does her story end though? After Krishna goes to Mathura, he has all the...
That's where it ends.
So, Is there
it's physical story. Internal story stays. They're ever there.
Right.
Never.
Always.
Always there. They're eternal. They're different looking, but eternally they are the same.
But there are no additional stories about her, what happened to her after Krishna left. There aren't, you know, she had different.
Krishna did not leave.
Sure.
Krishna did not leave Vrindavan, only his expenses left. Krishna stayed in Vrindavan, never left Vrindavan. Krishna in Vrindavan with 2 hours. When expenses left, he develops 4 hours too. You see, in Mathura, he had 4 arms in one time. In Kurukshetra, he got 4 arms sometimes. In Dwarka, he always 4 arms and sometimes 2 arms. So Krishna is 2 arms in Vrindavan. Original Krishna never left. Original stayed there, but unseen to the eyes. Radharani and Krishna, they are always there performing pastime. If you happen to come to Vrindavan for a few days, 2 days, 3 days, like you spent here, if you happen to come and I'm there, you remind me, you will go to the places. So I will tell you all the details where Lord Krishna met first time with Radharani. The spot is. The spot is still there. The places are still there.
We didn't go there yet. Prem sir.
What happened is?
No. We didn't make it yet.
What happened is, we are in Hari.
Yes.
And then that Panda got involved with us, and I got a little different, and we had a plan differently in a very short time.
Plus,
you and me will go. Nobody will touch us. And if I go with them, nobody will touch us too. But we will go with telling our story. Maybe we will all go. We'll see.
That's okay.
We will go in the morning, come back in the evening. You understand? It's only 30 kilometers, total 50 kilometers total. Total running around. Half an hour, 10 minutes there, half an hour there. Long like this place, you go to the temples and you'll see the sun. But there are no temples where these place people met there. There are only lakes or waterfalls. See, there are no temples, there are only trees. It's very nice place. Nobody will harm you, will be 1,000,000% secure. And but you also see the spots physically. You see, read black and white on the paper, and also see physically, then you develop more attraction.
Did you want to ask about the dance? Did you want to, you had some questions about the gopis and the dance.
I don't think
we'll
have enough time
now. We might. We're lucky there's no
right
now. We have.
You see, if we woke up Prithivasi premature, if I knew that you would be staying this long, I would not wake up. Whole day.
I know. See what happened. The taxi guy supposed to come, and taxi guy took somebody out for morning. So we are stuck here for now until we are in second place. That's it.
We can get a taxi here. If I tell Prithivasi, we'll get a taxi from here.
Wow.
Taxis are everywhere. It's a big city. This is Allahabad, a big city.
Let's give them a little bit of time, and then we might do. I'm not doing
it. He can only maintain. But Lord Krishna, he can do anything he wants. So that is Krishna. Sometimes he sends his incarnation, sometimes he comes himself. So this Dwapara Yuga, he came himself. Sometimes Rashtrapati may send a secretary or private secretary or chief secretary to him to get his work done. Sometimes he lends his helicopter to your village and gets his work done. Because Rashtrapati came this time to your house, therefore Rashtrapati has just been elected. No, he is existing already, living in his bhavan. So same way, Krishna is always there, and sometimes whenever it is required, paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya sadhuskritam, so whenever it is required to get some work done, he sends his incarnation, avatar. But sometimes he himself comes. Why he came this time? Why? Why he did not come before? Rama is avatar. Narsingha is avatar. Balaram is avatar. Krishna is not avatar. But in South India they put in Krishna is, but they have no proof. They have proof. When two lawyers are fighting in front of the judge and you prove and I have no proof, who will be deciding? So we have proof. We have substantiated proof, solid proof, black and white proof. We have proof. They have proof. They say, right after Rama is Krishna. Krishna. They put a phone. They put a phone. That is, they don't have proof. Right after Krishna is Balarama. Krishna incarnated in the 10 forms. We had this argument there in Vijayawada a few years ago, 3 years ago. One learned, who is retired principal of some big college, Sanskrit.
It is some
learned. Matlaadu vaddu, me petti po. Matlaadu vaddu po. She sung a Telugu song, 10 incarnations, and that Krishna was put there, not Balarama. So, because I understand more or less beat up Telugu, so I'm beat up Telugu, so I understood a little bit and I spoke beat up Telugu. So this guy, I did not know, this is a retired principal sitting there, so he supported. Yes, yes, I know, they are wrong. But you know, this is going on in Andhra Pradesh, so I keep mum. I said, you are getting all sent, everybody. Because because they are making mistakes they don't know, and you know, you don't tell them, you get all their sins. So we discussed about it. He translated the name. But translation is always translation when I speak is different. So what happened? Lord Krishna, anything he wants, he can do. This time he wanted to come. Why? The reason. Radharani was cursed. Radha and Krishna live up there. She was cursed. Proofs are there. She was cursed to come down on the earth. She made some kind of mischief there. Means got angry and accused somebody. Because there is also fights are everywhere. There is also quarrel. Not fighting means not hooting and punching, but it's quarrel. So this quarrel, Radharani was cursed to come down here. So Radharani came down 1 year before Lord Krishna came. So their decisions were made there before she came down. So okay, you are going, then I will come. So that's why Krishna came. Krishna came because of Radharani. Not only because of Radharani, but devotees prayed in Treta Yugam Dandakaranyam, prayed to Lord, the Supreme Lord, please let me become your wife. But there is only not one, there are thousands of sages. Please, we want to serve you as your wife.
To Rama, they
say. No, to the Lord, to the Supreme Lord, they pray.
No, wait.
Then Lord Rama came. Lord Rama came in Dandakaranyam forest when Sita is all that. You know the whole story. Then they pray to him. Then previously they are praying. That's why Lord Rama came. So they're saying, we want to become your wives. See, you know only after that. We know before that too. See, if our knowledge is limited, we make mistakes. It is called in English, it's called haphazardous knowledge. You see, it's hazardous. Very. You see, spiritual life is so wonderful. You have to know any way out. Out way in, any way out. Then it functions very nicely. So what happens? They pray to the place. Holding hands, they pray. Oh Lord, we want to bless the young ones. So he said, okay, I will have a scripture. Next time, he's telling them. And then, when he's marrying Sita, all these girls, because you are a royal fellow, you can get more than one wife. So he said, no, my maryada. Lord, Supreme Lord is never under maryada. That means he's limited to maryada. Maryada means within the boundaries, within the limits, within, he's bound by the rope. Like you go to this roof, then you're bound to stay within the roof, otherwise you'll fall and die. So Lord Rama bounded himself within limited God. He's not, God means unlimited. So he said, no, I cannot marry. I'm following some rules. So therefore, God means he follows rules and not follow rules. He breaks rules, he builds rules. He makes rules and he breaks them too. That is supreme, that is power, that is Lord. So Lord Krishna did all this. He got married and also did all this. 20 million gopis now danced with him. There were all these Dandakaranya rishis. There were all these girls of Janakpuri, they were all wives of heaven, the demigods, they were all Rishi Munis, the Vedas, Richas, all these scriptural evidences, they came down. 20 million gopis danced in one night in Lord Krishna. And they got kissed, they got embraced by him. So secret is, in spiritual life, we must understand it correctly, then everything will go for it, otherwise we will be in trouble. These pandits, they talk like this, they come to me too, and I invite them, I pay them to Vrindavan, I invite them, many of them have come. Pandit means they charge money. Swamis don't charge money, they don't charge, they have come to your house. You don't pay me, I come to your house. You pay me, you give me now. Why do you know? So, I ask questions. One very learned pandit came from Varanasi. before these pandits come from Brahma, before that. We discussed, very nice pandit. He spoke English. Old, 70 years old. I said, you say Krishna came from Narayana. We discussed it. And then Bhagavatam was printed in Telugu. I gave you one. You, did you read it? You read it? You're reading. How many pages you read? 40 pages. Oh, 40 pages. Slowly you're reading. You're too slow. I don't think you should read that slow. Because I want you to read three times. Then you will understand. And then you will have million questions. All your doubts till now will be removed. And you will have new questions. Can you tell me how the spiritual world looks? Then I will tell you, I can bring you a picture in front of your eyes with my pen and my paper. I will create everything on your table. Your questions will be different. Now, you read that book and read three times. When you see me or we see together, I told you about it. I really don't want him to die like me. I don't want him to go with you. I want to help my father. Can you help me bring him to me with all the line? He said, of course! Of course! I said, hey! You cannot guarantee. Son supposed to give this kind of guarantee. Even son cannot give. No, no. He will listen to me. He will do anything for me. Oh, really? Because you are a little girl, possibly he loves you a little more. I thought like that. All right, you came, I'm happy. But I want you to make your daughter's word come true. Like Lord Krishna makes your, that his devotee's words come true. Prahlad told this pillar has Krishna inside. But Prahlad had in mind such a lion form Krishna, so Nrisimha appeared. Stone don't have life. So how come stone produced Krishna in the form of Nrisimha? Because Lord did not want his devotee's words turned to untrue. I'm sure you love your daughter, you will not let her words go untrue. Said, of course! Of course, I will bring him to. That is echoing in my head. I was surprised. But it's wonderful. We want that happen. But it should not happen like a village fellow who is not educated. It should happen in a smart way because you are a lawyer educated. Your profession is speaking. Profession. We should talk like lawyers on speaking. I had found one lawyer in Kanpur. He was a big lawyer, very famous in whole city, Kanpur. We had a discussion. He said, discussion happened so great. It was very happy news, but the old man expired. The secret is, we will all expire. Before we expire, we make our lives successful. The real successful life is bright future. The future is after death. People think tomorrow is my future, 10 years later is my future. That is stupidity. That is not future. Future is after death. We must prepare after death, for after death. If I have a court case, I get a lawyer, he prepares my case and I go to judge for a day. Then he will fight for me. I cannot fight. I don't know how to prepare my life. Before reaching there, if I prepared my case properly, I am sure I will win. But I go there empty-handed, then I lose everything. So we have to face a court then. We must be prepared. And Guru is the lawyer who fights. But you don't know how to fight them? Do you know how to fight in the court? No. You get a lawyer, even though you are a doctor, but different field, you got to get a lawyer. And he will fight, he will prepare all your case properly with evidences from the books. And then he will go there and win your case, similarly. we must not go in a place where we have to suffer. Scriptures are not lies. They are true. They are facts.
And by the time of creation, there is hell and there is heaven?
At the it's what created, see? Just like a king creates his, arranges his, kingdom. King means ruler, anybody. Nowadays no king, so we say rulers. Ruler always wants his citizen to be perfect. He builds universities, he builds colleges, he builds recreations, he builds roads, he builds security, he does everything. He don't want criminals inside his kingdom. Some people happen to become criminals because there is a nature, second nature of everyone. Second nature, first nature of us, everybody, is to be good. Second nature is to be bad. Everybody. So, some people become bad. What he does, he becomes helpless. He creates jails. Jailhouse is also creation of the king, the ruler. Jailhouse. So some criminals are put there for reformation and punishment. Similarly, when creation was created, everybody wanted to be, we wanted to be good people, all Brahma wanted all that. But some people acted obnoxiously, sinfully. So hell was created. Previously was only one hell, then became 18 hells, then became 18,000 hells. Then became 84,000 hells. Because different kinds of sins, different kinds of... You know, you are being lawyer. Possibly you are a civil lawyer, not a criminal. Criminals know how many kinds. The police know this 302, this is 503, 203 A and B. So many grades are there. Similarly, there are grades of 8,400,000 kinds of hells on the person is sent there to a punishment.
Depending upon the symptom coming to you.
Yes. Now, what is the jailhouse? Jailhouse is called correctionary. In America, they don't call it jailhouse. Very few people call it jailhouse. Correctionary is called correction institute. Similarly, this hell. Hell is just like you. I embrace your wife. She's not my wife, but I embrace your wife, your daughter. Even though she's married to somebody else, I embrace her seductively. But that is wrong. So I go there, I'm given to certain kind of hell, I embrace an iron, red heart woman there. And person does not die there because if the body dies, the body is left here, but there is a subtle body, sukma sarira. Sukma Sariram does not die, therefore I suffer. So, we call reformatory. Hell is cruel world. We call it reformatory. Institution created by Lord Brahma at the time of creation when people became rebellious to his rules and acted obnoxiously, therefore that hell is created. Hell and heaven are within this creation of Lord Brahma. Spiritual world, Vaikuntham, is above the creation of Lord Brahma. So when we shoot for heaven, because I was very pious, gave charities, built temples, will bring Swamiji's and print books, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, go to religious places, holy places, and chant japam, yajna, all this is pious activities. So I go to heaven. Heaven is also within the creation of Lord Brahma. So within the creation of Lord Brahma has to be birth, taken birth and then death. Birth and death is within the creation of Lord Brahma. So when we shoot out of this cell covering of this creation, go to Vaikuntha, then there is no birth and death. How to go there, how to cross this cell of this universe, how to make a hole within this cell, is Guru makes the hole. Guru is required. We have to accept somebody as guru. I have to accept a lawyer to fight my case. I have to accept a teacher, a professor, an somebody to teach me so I can get a certified educator. Like that is necessary. Then we make a hole in the cell of the universe and shoot up to my.
So the original Krishna is again born?
No, not born, appear.
Appear as Krishna?
As Krishna. Like Rashtrapati come, I told you, like Rashtrapati came to your house, or he sent his messenger, Viceroy, previously with Viceroys, you know, what was Viceroy, those kingdom days. So like that, so Krishna sent Viceroys, means avatars. But he came this time because Radharani came down.
So we are not worshipping Krishna as Dwaparayuga Krishna.
We are worshipping Lord Krishna, the original who appeared in Dwapara Yuga.
Not Krishna is not the son of Yashoda.
There also, Mother Yashoda, you see.
Original.
Nobody can become parents of God. It's not possible. When Bhagavatam Parikshit Maharaj was told by Sukadeva Vasuka Maharshi that these Mother and Yashoda were performing austerity in their past life and Lord Brahma gave them that Lord Krishna will come to you as your son. He developed that. How can God appear by the boon of a Brahma who is mortal? Lord Brahma is also mortal because within the cell of creation. So Lord Brahma is mortal. How can a mortal demigod give a boon to somebody saying that God will become your child? He developed a smart man, asking a smart question. So he said, no. Nanda and Yashoda were pushing in the past life. But that is not really actually true. This is permanent parents of Lord Krishna. They are performing Leela in the spiritual world. Lord Krishna performs Leela always because he is Leela Dhari. They perform Leela means doing playful plays. Then doing there. So they are permanent parents. They came down to act as parents here. So they took birth before Lord Krishna. They performed little austerity and made little, received the foretelling from Lord Brahma. But it is not a fact. These are permanent parents of Lord Krishna. This is Srimad Bhagavatam. So the secret is, we must follow scriptures. The judge is looking to you how much evidence you have produced.
Why are not these people scholars? They are not following these scriptures. No scriptures.
Because these are modern scholars. They are just namesake scholars. They are not.
Which are same? All scriptures.
Oh, naturally.
Vedas are all.
Naturally, sir. How can there be South Indian Veda and North Indian Veda? The Vedas are one. Same scriptures, same books. They cannot talk.
And the
Shankaracharya, what do they say? Shankaracharya is Mayavadam Asatsastram Prachinnam Bhauti Puchyate Mayyeva Kalpitam Devi Kalau Brahmana Rupana. Lord Shiva tells Parvati, I am being ordered by Lord Krishna to appear as Brahman and Kalpita and create Mayavad philosophy. I am God, you are God. This is no, this is nothing than, nothing other than atheism. He's telling you, these are all atheists. Government is supporting Shankaracharya because Shankaracharya knows some politics. So that's why they are supporting original Shankaracharya. He said, He made four seats in four forms of India and he laid down. He said, this is enough for me. I want to ask them. These four people came and asked me for questions. Who is the real God? Second disciple asked, which book will you read? There are so many books. Which is the best book and which will give salvation? The third one asked, what is that mantra? You can chant, or anybody can chant, get motion. And fourth one asked, what is that service we must do, by doing which we can get motion, blessings of God? Four questions were asked, and he's telling, one spoke. He says, Eko Deva Deva Putra. Only one God is Krishna. But because he knows these people, they misinterpret. Because so many people have Krishna names. Then you know, he says, Son of Devaki. Son of Devaki is only one of Krishna. Your name can also be Krishna, but not Son of Devaki. Therefore, not you Krishna, but that Krishna. Eka Deva, there's only one God. And then, Eko Grantha, only one Grantha should be read. That is the Bhagavad Gita. He's telling. They're thinking, our Guru has gone crazy, mad. Because he's telling all the time, all his life, that you are God, I am God, God is zero, God is just light, he's unborn, ajanma, and all that. Whole life he's told like this, now he's telling like this. There's something wrong with him. So he said, Eko mantra tasya namaniyam. Chant only one mantra. That tasya nama is Krishna. Krishna is talking, Krishna is Deva. His book, his book should be read, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita. And his mantra in which his names are repeated. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Repeated. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Repeated. So, tasya namani yani. Karmapi, dharmapi, ekaha tasya deva sesha. Tasya means Krishna again. Do devotional service to him. Only one thing. Ekaha. Only one thing you should do in your lifetime. That is bhakti. Oh, our Guru has gone crazy. So he says, O Parvati, Lord Shiva says, I will incarnate as Brahma and take sannyas. And produce Mayavad Shastra. Mayavad means atheism. Mayavadam asat shastra. Sat shastra ledu. Asat shastra. This is Padma Purana. 5,000 years ago, Vyasa Maharshi wrote, Shlokas don't come in my house. Not, I don't produce in the kitchen. Mayavadam asat shastram. Sat shastram ledu Shankaracharya. I talk like this everywhere. No Shankaracharya comes to me to refute this. Everywhere in Kumbh Mela and Haridwar is Mayavad place. Haridwar, Rishikesh is total Mayavad place. No Vaishnavas are there. Banaras is total Mayavad place. No Vaishnavas they live there. I talk like this in the speakers. Mayavadam asat shastram. Tell me, how is your shastra? It's sat. Sat means true. Your shastra, your preaching is all untrue. Lord Shiva speaks. That to Parvati. Prachinnam bauddhamuchyate. It is actually Buddhism. Buddhism is atheism. It is actually hidden atheism. Mayeva kalpitam devi. Lord Shiva says, oh devi, it is me. Kalpitam means kalpita shastra. Speculation. Not true. It's now evidence in the scriptures. This is it. They are politicians. Bunch of politicians sitting there. It's a politics. Swami not supposed to talk about nation. Supposed to talk about your liberation. Why talk politics? What is this? Doing Muslim and Hindu fightings and all that, they are involved. This party, that party supporting, that is not Swami's business. Swami's business is how you receive a liberation, how I can get liberated. Swami is supposed to perform tapasya, austerities, shastra chintanam, puja, seva, directing everybody to Krishna. That is Swami's business. You go out of Swami's business, you get criticized. People criticize Ramdev Baba, put him in the handcuffs, tie him in the jailhouse. Why they have to do that? That is not business of Swami. A donkey should not do dog's job. Dog's job is to do dog's job. If you are not dog, don't do dog's job. That is spiritual. I mean, stop that.
Then why did Shiva do this?
I tell you this now. That is the way to talk. See? If you ask questions like this, all your doubts will be removed. You will become like this multi-millionaire speaking devotee. Whole house is devotion. Whole house is a temple. These very rich people, double Tata and Birlas. Very rich American. Why Lord Shiva did this? Lord Krishna ordered him to do that. He's telling us. Now tell him Parvati. He's telling, I am being ordered to take birth as a Brahmin, take sannyas and do Kantra Sastra. He's telling. Why Lord Krishna ordered him to do that? Because before Shankaracharya, Shankaracharya appeared 1300 years ago. Seventh century. But Lord Buddha appeared 2,500 years ago.
Earlier.
2,500 years ago. Lord Buddha appeared. So Lord Buddha criticized Vedas. Because Brahmins misunderstood Vedas and killing cows, animals, and even human beings, and chopping them swaha swaha and giving them prasad. Giving them prasad. So they misunderstood the Vedas. It is not said like that in the Vedas. So Lord Krishna incarnated as Buddha to criticize Vedas. Criticizing Vedas, ignoring Vedas means they are atheists. The whole India became Buddhist because it prevailed all over India. Buddha is incarnation of Krishna, anything he spoke. The people accepted, they all became against Vedas. They became Ahimsavadi Buddhists. And everybody in India became Buddhists. Lord Krishna decided, okay, now everybody is not following Veda, misunderstood Veda. Now there is no more misunderstanding left. Let me go slowly develop them. So he told Shankara, you go there as a Brahmin, take sannyas and preach about Vedas. Then, but Kalpita Shastra, you go Kalpita Shastra, produce your own speculation, tell them. So people can accept Vedas. So he came, no, Vedas are not bad, Vedas are good. Let me tell you what, God is in you, God is in me. I realize that I am God. You have not yet realized, therefore you think you are not God, but actually you are God.
Advaita.
Yes. Advaita means Maya. See, so you go and tell this. So he came down and started speaking this. But because he is a devotee, Lord Shiva is the best devotee of Lord Krishna. The topmost devotee among this creation, among everybody, is Lord Shiva. The topmost devotee. Vaishnavanam Yathashakti. Yathar Nadinam Ganga. Among all the rivers, Ganges is the best. Similarly, among all devotees, Lord Shiva is the best. The best devotee. As he is a devotee, as Lord Shiva, incarnated as a Brahmin to preach orders of Lord Shiva, or orders of Lord Krishna, as Mayavad philosophy, I am God, you are God, but he is a devotee by nature. So he at the end said, Bhajan, Eko Deva, Deva. See? So, that happened. After that came Rama. 8th century. Ramanujacharya says, Advaita no, Advaita is not good. This is Advaita. You are God, but you are not actually God. You are quality God.
Is also South?
Yes, also South. Most of the acharyas are Practically nobody is in Prabhupada. No. No. Four acharyas are all are. Why they are not following devotion so much the right way? Because of Ravana's influence is also there. Little bit Ravana influence is there. Ravana was a disciple and devotee of Lord Shiva. So most of the people there, they follow Lord Shiva, even though there are very few original temples of Lord Shiva in the south. In the north, Badrinath, Kedarnath is there. Kedarnath is Lord Shiva. Amarnath is Lord Shiva, Muktinath is Lord Shiva, Pashupati. These are original temples. At the time of creation they came, they are built later on, 1000 years, 500 years, 800 years, 2000 years, Vacharya temples, 5,000, 20,000, 100,000, million years, there are no temples. There are temples in the north, but they don't accept Lord Shiva to be totally. Even though preaching of Shankara went to the north also, they don't, all of them don't accept Lord Shiva to be the original God. But in the south, 99% people think that. Why? Because of pandits. I don't know now. Influence of Ravana dynasty might be there. I think like that. I don't know. Not sure. Anything devotee is not sure, will tell. He's not sure. But what is your even emphatically tell? Emphatic means by force. Even tell if this true. This is 100 rupee note, and you will tell me it is true. It is 100 rupee note, sir. I can fight with you in the court. It is not a paper. It is 100 rupee note. Why? Because you see the government stamp. So then came. No, you are not God. You cannot be God. It's impossible you can be God. Not possible. Because previously, Shankaracharya had told a drop of ocean carries the same quality. The same, this drop of ocean is also ocean. Because it came out from ocean, it is ocean. So the Vishishtadvaita said, no, it is drop, it is ocean. Even though it is come out from ocean, but it's not ocean, it's drop, he said. Madhvacharya came, no, it is not ocean, he says. And drop cannot be compared with the soul because it's all dead matter. This is spirit, soul, a life. This is a life body, this is a dead matter. Ocean drop is dead. It is matter, it is life. You cannot compare. He came with a force. So two fingers, it's impossible. You can never become God, you are never God. Not possible. See, slowly developing Indian philosophy, slowly developing the patterns. First, misunderstood everything by Buddha. Buddha came. Vedas were misunderstood.
That is also
incarnation. Yes, Buddha. Madhu, Karuna Prachara, Ahimsa Madhu, non-violence. So, Buddha came, made everybody non-violent, removed the Vedas. Shankaracharya came, established the Vedas, but preaches.
Vedas are not preaching.
There is breathing of God. Came from a breathing of God. So, then slowly developed by Ramanujacharya, saying that yes, but it is a drop, there is ocean, there is a difference, he said. Even though there is quality same Upunila, Kani, it is drop and that is ocean. He said, then Madhvacharya came, said like this, then came Dhammaracharya. Hey, you cannot do that. When you put that drop into the ocean, it don't become drop. It still remains a drop. Then came Vishnu Swami. No, don't worry, it's too much for you to understand. You follow Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya says, drop is dead matter, ocean is also dead matter, Supreme Lord is supreme life, and this living entity is small life. Life can be compared with life, cannot be compared with the dead matter.
Okay, okay, yes, yes. Wonderful. Okay, wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. ఎవరైనా సరే వెళ్తారో ఇంకా పాటలు మీరు
తీసుకుంటారు
కరెక్ట్ మంచిది మీకు చాలా బుద్ధి ఉంది మీరు తీసుకోండి ప్రతిరోజు స్నానం గోవిందేతి సదా స్నానం గోవిందేతి సదా ధ్యానం గోవిందేతి సదా జప గోవిందేతి సదా స్నానం విఆర్ టేకింగ్ దిస్ ఇస్ అ రియల్ గైడ్ ఫిలాసఫీ స్నానం కృష్ణ Krishna, science of Krishna. This Ganges is better. But because we are here, we can also go and dip inside. 24 hours there and 12 hours sun is there. Anytime we can go and dip inside, because Amrutam time finished yesterday, now it's normal day, every day. It becomes tree. You cannot see because it is inside the green leaves. Green parrot inside the green tree. Don't become tree. Life. Supreme life, individual life. Both are lives. The tree is a life, parrot is a life. Flow into the tree, never become tree. It can fly out again. But it became one in color.
Appears to be.
No, became one with color. Appears to be tree, but it's one with color. Similarly, we become one with God in purpose, but not God. Even though you cannot see the green parrot inside the tree, the tree is individually separate from the individual parrot, always remains separate. Similarly, if we go to the spiritual world, still we remain individual. For example, you have a typewriter in the office, your secretary is typing, okay? Now you decided to go to the spiritual world, you take your typewriter with you. Typewriter don't become a human being there. It's already still a typewriter, tuck, 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 if you push button, it will do tuck. If you push another button, it will do tuck. That is his business. So similarly, our business is to love somebody and to service. I love your wife, therefore I do some service. Mama, ama, ama, kudi prasadhirani. Did he catch me? So this is service attitude and loving attitude. So we love Krishna there and serve. Because if you push the button, you will tuck. Our duty is to love and to serve. So we do serve and we love. Love Krishna and serve Krishna. That is our constitutional position, unchangeable. All circumstances, at all time, and all places. So we must serve, but we must follow rules of the scriptures. Scriptures. Yeah?
राधे राधे श्याम जय जय श्री राधे जय जय श्री राधे पूज्यपाद महामंडलेश्वर महान श्री कृष्ण राम स्वामी महाराज की जय जय श्री राधे श्याम।
Thank you.
श्रीपाद महामंडलेश्वर महंत श्री कृष्ण राम स्वामी महाराज की
जय। विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य श्रोत्रशत श्री श्री श्रीमत्
प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री द्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। श्री मथुरा धाम की जय। श्री द्वारिकापुरी धाम की जय। श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। श्री श्री राधा गोविंद जी की जय। तुलसी देवी भक्ति देवी की जय। गंगा माई यमुना माई की जय। समागत भक्त वृंद की जय। गौर प्रेमानंदी
जय। ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य पूज्यपाद महामंडलेश्वर महंत श्री कृष्ण बलराम स्वामी जी महाराज की। भागवत धर्म समाज संस्थापक आचार्य पूज्यपाद महामंडलेश्वर महंत श्री कृष्ण बलराम स्वामी जी महाराज की। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की। कलयुग धर्म हरि नाम संकीर्तन की। गौरव प्रेमानंदी
Oh,
सुखदेव भगवान की, प्रहलाद महाराज की, श्री राधा गुण भगवान की, वृंदावन धाम की, जय जय श्री राधे श्याम।